ocean, over the clouds, and around the world. Here comes the wild side of wildlife.
The Animal Show!
And now let's have a wild welcome for your furry friends,
Stinky and Jake!
Now it's the Animal Show!
Hello, all you little animals out there.
I'm Stinky.
And I'm Jake. And today we're going to meet the owl and the frog, two nocturnal animals.
What does nocturnal mean, Jake?
Well, it just means that the owl and the frog are more active at night than they are during the day.
Oh, well, you know, skunks are more active at night, too. Mm-hmm. That means three animals on today's show like nighttime best. The owl, the frog, and...
Right.
That settles it.
Settles what?
Where's the light switch, Jake?
Light switch? Oh, why do I have a bad feeling about this? Oh, yeah, that's why.
Now it's time for...
That's amazing! Today, let's look at the world's largest and oldest owl. The great eagle owl is the world's largest owl. Its wingspan can stretch as much as 6 feet, and it can weigh more than 8 pounds.
Dude, that's a whole lot of owl.
It's the world's oldest owl, too.
Who? Him?
He can live for up to 68 years, longer than any other owl. The Great Eagle Owl.
A big old bird that'll light up your night and make you say...
That's amazing!
Bunny, could we borrow your flashlight?
Just coming! Here you go, Cousin Jakey. I got something even better.
Oh, that's nice. Thank you, Bunny.
Okay.
All right, and now it's time to learn more about the nightlife. So let's bring out our first guest from the world's woodlands, deserts, and tundras.
Tundras.
Here's Timothy the owl.
Well, now this is a fine-looking place. Dark as night, just the way I like it. But,
wow!
But what is with this bright light?
Oh, I'm sorry about the lantern there, Timothy. Jake isn't nocturnal like you and I.
Oh, a shame that. And nighttime is the right time when it comes to owls. Oh, I rhyme.
Rhyme.
Let me show you what I mean by taking a look at my favorite owls.
Well, now, who is that?
Oh, that is a barn owl.
Oh. Does he live in a barn?
Some barn owls do, Stinky. That's how it got its name. But some barn owls live in the rafters of an empty house, or in the case of this particular fellow, in the church next to an old graveyard.
Graveyard?
Some folks used to think barn owls were ghosts because of the way they flew so quietly through the graveyards. And then they disappear into rafters like this.
Gosh, I noticed that you owls have very fluffy feathers.
Ah, fluffy they are. And that's not just for beauty, you know. Our feathers are extra thick, like a down coat, to keep us warm on cold nights when we may sit for hours waiting for a meal to wander by. The long feathers on that owl's wing are called flight feathers. They've got a very soft layer of down on the top and bottom.
Well, what does that do?
It means our wings make very little noise when they flap. We fly more quietly than most any other birds.
Hmm, Timothy, is it true that owls have good eyesight?
Oh, that we do. It's almost 100 times better than a human being's eyesight. And as if we weren't amazing enough, we can move our heads almost all the way around.
Well, what are owl families like?
Oh, I'm so glad you asked, Jake. I just happen to have some photographs. There's a mother owl tending to her young. She'll stay with them and keep them warm until they're ready to fly.
But how long will that be?
For barn owls like these, about 6 or 7 weeks. Great eagle owls fly after about 2 months. But those wee pygmy owls start flying after only a month.
Oh, way to go, wee pygmy owls.
Now, how many chicks do owls usually have?
That all depends on how much food is around. If there's a lot of good eating to be had, a mother owl may lay 4 to 6 eggs. But if food is hard to find, she may not lay any eggs at all.
Well, it must be a pretty good year for this owl if she hatched all those chicks.
That it is. But having chicks is a lot of work. She and the father owl have to bring back enough food to feed the whole family.
Well, how does that work?
Well, Jake, while one owl stays with the young, the other goes out hunting. It's difficult enough hunting for yourself, but hunting for a family means a lot more flights into the night. Ooh, another rhyme.
You know, being a nocturnal animal doesn't sound so bad.
Well, if you ask me, Jake, nightlife is the best. The darkness of the night gives ours an extra advantage.
And that makes it a little easier for you to bring home dinner for you and your family.
It's true, Jake. But even with our great eyesight, it can be tough for owls to see what's out there in the dark. But here's a secret. We have very good ears.
I don't see any ears.
Ah, that is because they're tucked away under our feathers. Not only can we hear over a great distance, but we can even figure out how far away a mouse or some meal is, just by listening to the sound it makes.
Well, thanks for telling us all about owls, Timothy.
Oh, it was my pleasure. And since it's dark, I've got to do some hunting. Remember, stay away from the light. Have a good night. Oh, I rhyme again.
Oh. Wow. Now, Stinky, now that the owl is gone, could we turn the lights back on in here?
Oh, of course not, Jake. Hmm? It's time for...
Baby talk.
I'm starving.
Here it is. I've got it. Lovely mouse.
Don't be
sweet. Don't worry. I cut it up for you. Here we go. Biting it into nice little pieces there.
Right. More.
Excuse me. Here's another bite. Here's a nice big bite for...
Oh, no, you don't. This is mine. Oh, more, please. Some more?
Here you go.
Thanks, that's more like it.
Oh, I'm getting this one.
Jake, we don't need more light.
But I want to be able to see what's going on.
Well, then turn out the lights, because what's going on is the nightlight.
Oh.
You can't beat the night as darkness creeps around you. You don't need the light as shadows will surround you. The moon shining bright's the only way.
Into that one, didn't I?
Yep.
The correct answer is...